الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه، ملء السماوات وملء الأرض وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء ربنا من شيء بعد. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم أجمعين. أما بعد، الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله. الله تعالى الرب كريم أرحم الراحمين. Through His فضل and كرم we are gathered here at this moment in time to share some ideas, find some solutions and then some lessons inshallah تبارك وتعالى بإذنه سبحانه about this very very needed topic matter, that one of the challenges of our time, what they call it Islamophobia. This is nothing new. It's nothing just happened in our time. It has been happening since the day one Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam received Ya ayyuha al-muzammir, Ya ayyuha al-muddathir, since day one of Islam. Those days, the different ways of Islamophobia were more effective because it was in person and was by making relatives the close to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to propagate, to take this Islamophobia to Quraysh and Arabs around Mecca, so they do not listen to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, be scared. So start from calling him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam names. And to those culture, those people, these names meant something, scaring people from coming nearby Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One of these, يُفَرِّقُ بَيْنَ الْمَرْءِ وَزَوْجِ يُفَرِّقُ بَيْنَ الْأَبِ وَابْنِ يُفَرِّقُ بَيْنَ يُفَرِّقُ. He's coming here to split people, to separate them, to cause troubles among the families and relatives. He, نعوذ بالله من ذلك, those who tried hard to get people away is from coming nearby or listening to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they called him كذاب, ساحر, مجنون, all these names. And by doing this in person is more effective, is much greater than what we think in social media. They pushed, they planned to his own uncle that we still recite in the Holy Quran, تَبَّتْ يَدَى أَبِي لَهَبٍ وَتَبْ أَبُو لَهَبْ. So people say, he should know about his own nephew more than anybody else. It's Abu Lahab, his own uncle. See, كذاب, مجنون. To scare people from Islam. And looking at the whole history, nothing new. So we should not be surprised. We shouldn't be very upset and react in not very pleasant way to this, and nothing new. The question is, they radiallahu anhum, Sahaba radiallahu anhum, and surely Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was ready for that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through wahy, revelation, and Sahaba radiallahu anhum through listening and watering Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they learned a lot. The Quran says to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَلَا يَحْزُنْكَ قَوْلُهُمْ إِنَّا نَعْلَمُ مَا يُسِرُّونَ وَمَا يُعْلِنُونَ. Do not be sorry. Do not have grief in your heart. We, Allah Jalla Jalalu, we know, surely we know what they hide in their heart and what they proclaim openly about you. It's nothing new. And he sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam dealt with this matter. And Sahaba radiallahu anhum dealt with this matter. Know that with the best. Know that with the best. We all understand any phobia has no real danger. It is irrational. We cannot logically see it's there. But the problem is not with those who got this phobia. The problem with the cause of this phobia, or what people think is the cause of this phobia, to confirm, to act in a way or another to confirm the phobia. Here is the problem. Some of us, knowingly or unknowingly, they know what they do or they don't. They act in a way scaring people from Islam. Islam is coming. Islam will do this. Islam will do that. So what those who are scaring people from Islam, some they confirm it. And this is the problem. The message of Islam have never been to impose, to force, to get people, to drag them as animals. Na'udhu billah. There is no religion, not just because we are Muslims, non-Muslims who are reasonable and sensible, they should, and they agree with us. There is no religion. Look at humans, as the best, the most honored on this earth than Islam. And Allah Jalla Jalla addressed these humans. وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ وَحَمَلْنَاهُمْ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ وَرَزَقْنَاهُمْ مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ وَفَضَّلْنَاهُمْ عَلَى كَثِيرٍ مِمَّنْ خَلَقْنَا تَفْضِيلًا. We take كَرَّمْنَا. Ye Allah Jalla Jalla honor this insan. And by honoring this insan, this human being, the Anbiya alayhim salatu wa salam, the Rasul of Allah Jalla Jalalu, they bore all the troubles. They faced all the troubles, including Islamophobia, including deen phobia, including iman phobia, with sabr and jameel. Fasbir ala ma yaqulu, have sabr. Be patient. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وهجرهم هجرا جميلا. From the fourth surah, Surah Al-Muzzammil, that was revealed to رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم and the Muddathir. What is هجرا جميلا? Forgive them. Forget what they say. In a beautiful, if we take it literally, جميلا, beautiful. In a very nice way. The ulama, they say, what's the hajr jameel? Sabr without complaining. Patience without complaining. They would say this, they would say that. So what you respond to them in this way? To make it easy for all of us, we need to work on three levels. Consider three actions and try two companionship to make a change. three levels. First, on oneself. How to solve this problem is starting from here, from oneself. إصلاح النفس, إصلاح الإنسان. What is إصلاح? Is self-rectification, self-purification. Before I am concerned about Islamophobia, let's say me, that's myself, phobia. The people are scared of me. So how I fix myself in a way that I build this confidence inside me. And Alhamdulillah, I'm talking about myself, as many of you, I travel in and out in this appearance, this attire. And I go to different universities and I meet with some high profile rank police, and possibly they are recording or listening to me somehow now. It's no problem. And we speak openly. As long as your message is the completely the opposite of what they call phobia. And the message that you bring in your life and your life speaks out this message is very easy. They don't have to read the whole Quran to find it. It's enough to read the first line in the Quran. What's the first line in the Quran? My respected brothers and respected sisters, first line when you open the book of Allah, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Who's Allah Jalla Jalal? Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim Jalla Jalal. The quality of Rahmah. Allah Rabbul Alameen, for all the beautiful names, the beautiful sifat, qualities, Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The opening chapter, that's we call it in author or any book way, is the preface. The opening chapter, Surah Al-Fatiha. Then we recite, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, again, Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The same page, Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, first line, and again they be repeated there. It's just by buzzing and hustles and computer programming, so just to happen, the words, it jump in, it meant to be there. It is there. So the first message I put in my heart to work on my nafs is Rahmah. And all the Anbiya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came through this. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when we recite this half of the ayah, end of the ayah, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا, every Muslim would say, للمسلمين, would say للعالمين. للعالمين. Again, the problem is, instead of they are scared of Islam, we should be scared about their future. The Anbiya alayhim salatu wassalam and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they all said to their nations, إني أخاف عليكم عذاب يوم أليم عذاب يوم عظيم. I'm really concerned about you. It is going to be a day, it's a severe day, it's a great day, it's a very difficult day, etc., etc. They were scared about the future of their people. So they scare people from Islam. They shun people away from Islam. The first is we become concerned more about them. We should have more rahmah for them. What was in the heart of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? No doubt, is rahmah. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no doubt, was hurt in his blessed person, in his blessed own family, in his blessed own relatives, and so on. We may accept because he had no such power when he was in Mecca. The examples I can give those who don't understand, when he sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam was in Medina al-Munawwara, known as Medina al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, city of the Prophet, from his blessed time sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Aus and Khazraj, the strong tribes of Medina, they were there. And then they gave bay'ah, they gave pledge to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to protect him from what they protected their own selves and their own women and families. In the modern term, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was head of the state. Got the power. For how many years he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lived there? And just a simple greeting from Yahud used to say, Assalamu alaykum, Assalamu alaykum, Al-Mawtu alaykum. Swearing upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Calling death to be upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took it calmly and said, Wa alaykum. Upon you. Aisha radiallahu anha, furious, angry. Ya Rasulullah, did you hear what they said? He said, I did. They said, Assalamu alaykum. He said, yes. And I said, Wa alaykum. So it's not just when he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam away, no, face to face. Imagine face to face. And the great Sahaba are there. And everyone got his sword sharpened enough to spread heads from bodies and put them down. It never happened. Never happened. And others and others. And the Mushrik and the Yahudi. And planning the evil plan. The big Iraq there waiting for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to come down and sit and then push it from there and let's get rid of this man. Did he sallallahu alaihi wasallam did anything? Many, many examples. The Jewish women that they planned together and then the woman put the most severe, very dangerous poison to kill Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to eat from the right arm of the shah, of that meat. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not punish him for any, but when one of the Sahaba radiallahu anhu died due to this food, then the qasas was there and Islam. We have to understand not to let some, very few of us, may Allah guide them, may Allah let them to learn. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open their hearts to see what is in the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And try to be sensible. And not try to be heroes. And in reality, knowledge-wise, zero. Of nothing. Because we don't learn from our scholars, our imams, our ulama. Indeed, no one will accept from Muslim or non-Muslim any respected figure to be insulted. We understand that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses us, even we cannot, we the Muslim, should not insult or swear at the enemies of Allah. وَلَا تَصُبُّ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ فَيَصُبُّ اللَّهَ عَدْوًا بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. Do not swear, don't use bad language on those who are enemies of Allah. They will answer you back. They will say the same. So don't do it. We cannot do it. And any sensible person will agree with us. So back to the first level, oneself. Make a change of oneself. Second, one own family. How to have this confidence, this faith in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in his message, in his sharia, in his deen sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, within our own family. I always remind myself and my dear students to take two actions. Two actions. If you have it, carry on. May Allah bless you. If you don't, consider it. Family consultation. Family shura. Mishwara. Mishwara. Sometimes even, I say, even in the family, if you want to, a young child is there, wants to buy ice cream. I say, inshallah, this ice cream will be blessed ice cream because it comes through Mashwara. We need to learn a degree above democracy. And we don't have just practice democracy when we go to parliament. We practice our own parliament with my mother, with my wife, with my sisters, sit together and say, what's the purpose of Shura today? Consultation today. We cannot make it every day. Make it once a week. Half an hour, 1 hour. Get a book and call it Family Mashwara, Family Shura. Write everything there. Allah Jalla Jalalu in Surah Al-Shura. The term Shura was inserted between Salah and Zakah. وَالَّذِينَ أَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَأَمْرُهُمْ شُورَى بَيْنَهُمْ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. Shura is in between the two pillars of Islam, Salat and Zakat. Some people say, is any place for democracy in Islam? Shura is above democracy. Democracy is one of the very weak and very corrupted version of Shura. Because it has a lot of game. Some maybe clean and nice games. As I know about some of my MPs, they may have this message. I know them personally, alhamdulillah. Yeah, back in Manchester, even the mayor, so. And some, you know, dirty games. How to play with the mass minds and these and that. To make them busy with something so we can play here and there. May Allah guide all Ya Rabbil Alameen. It's a very short life. Today or tomorrow we have to all stand in front of our Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our creator, and we have to give answers. Muslims and non-Muslims, no exception, because they don't believe in the hereafter. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you don't believe in me. Okay, fine. You are forgiving. It's not enough. They have to prepare for that. And you know, everything has a beginning, has an end. So in one's family, oneself, one's family, and local community. With the local community, not just our few streets around us, in your city, we need to consider these three actions. First action, how to turn the challenge to an opportunity. The challenge. Yes, good. They awaken us up. We are supposed to go and look for an opportunity. Now they are giving it to us. We should thank them. And subhanAllah, after any trouble from the Khomeini revolution in Iran, from here, I don't have to mention the list, you know, after any of these events, subhanAllah, many are coming back. I said back. To Islam, may revert to Islam. Why? Because every Muslim believes every other non-Muslim is born as Muslim. And this is one of the nice the personal experience. You may try it in a good way, in a nice way. You speak to some of your colleagues, or oh, by the way, I understand he was born as Muslims. And look at the reaction. The reaction of that lady or of that brother in humanity. They say, no. This is what I believe. And go and ask any Muslims. Oh, really? So they'll call Mr. Muhammad and Mr. Patel and Mr. in the office or in the hospital. Do you really believe that this man, this crazy one, that thinks I was born as Muslims? I was born even atheist. I don't believe in anything. And this one believe that I was born as Muslims. The other Muslim bro or sister bro, they look at each other. Should we tell him the truth? Or we've been affected more by the Islamophobia than them. Do you believe that I was born as Muslims? Can you look at me? I have nothing to do with you people. You Paki? Then say, you have to excuse us. Yeah, my parents or my grandparents, they said that. What about you? Do you believe in it? So this is the Islamophobia that we have. He said, yes, I believe this. This is our prophet. And your prophet, again, open his eyes, my prophet. Who's that? Do I have a prophet? He said, yeah, his name is Muhammad. Really? Yes. Again, this 1 billion and something of the people on the earth believe so. Nearly one-fifth of the population of this earth believe so, that this one was sent to you as well. But the problem is you don't know him. So take the challenge and opportunity. May Allah help us to do this. Amen. But what is the first? The first line in the Quran, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The second, learn how to respond in a legal, in a nice way. We just, in a small group or big sectors, whatsoever, school of thought, take action. Angry. Who speak in this way, this not accepted way about our Quran, about our Rasul, about this or that? Nobody can do that. Who dare to speak in this way? We're angry. Don't try to be more Muslim, I say sometimes, more Muslim than the Sahaba. Calm down, my brother, my sister, calm down. Don't try to be more than them. They led the way. They showed us how to react. So act in this way. In our time, because what we have, letters, we have petitions, we are going and speaking in person to your responsible people and tell them that nobody should accept it this way. And how can we work together in a way to stop this to being repeated and dissolve this unnecessary tension between Muslims and non-Muslims? And this is the third here. Let us be engaged with them. Open our doors for behaving away with these two questions in your mind. If our beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is here with us, what he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would do, what he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would do, would cry for them. Would raise his hand sallallahu alayhi wa sallam night and day for them. Would he? He did. His own people. Then whom by all means, they troubled his blessed person, his name, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his own family, by all means, put all thought of troubles. As they say, they didn't leave stone unturned, but find any troubles under it to give it to Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Knew that. So work in the faith. We, the first of the three religions, mashallah, called the Abrahamic foundation, of the Abrahamic, we the only religion that got branched in sciences, in ulum, it's called Muqaranatul Adiyan, comparative religions, we have it. Do they have it? When they study about Islam, not to study Islam, two different things. When we study Christianity, not about Christianity. Because we still believe there must be a lot that was revealed to our Nabi, Isa alayhi salam, as our Nabi as the Nabi, no doubt. And Musa and Ibrahim alayhi salam still there. But translation, of interpretation, of some people who don't know the chain of holding all this. And what they have in the old scriptures, they have stories of their prophet's life. What is for us comparing with Sirah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, biography of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Above the Sirah we have hadith, that chain of narrators, that no other nation has this except the Muslims. Alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah, one like humble myself. Who's my sheikh? Sheikh of sheikh till the 60 kitabs of Sahih, or mashallah known in hadith. in Quran, this. We say, and still the native language was spoken by our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When you speak to the people that age, you have witnesses. It's not that easy to try to compare what you have, what we, the Muslim have. If you bring a translation of the Book of Allah in any language, and you try to convince me this is a Book of God, the Quran, the meanings of the Quran, there is no one Muslim will accept it. So now you bring translation, interpretation in a different language of your Bible, and you try to convince a Muslim this is the Book of God, or this is the Word of God. And no one is going to that, accept it. There is no way. There's no way. I cannot accept the Book of Allah, the Quran, in any other language. How can you try to bring an English version of your Bible and say this is God's word? Doesn't make sense. In a matter of half a minute conversation, simple and easy. So these three actions turn the challenge to an opportunity. Learn how to respond and engage. Can we make a word of this? People like yourselves, mashallah, like to have keyword before they leave. Or, isn't it? O-R-E, what does mean or? Yeah, I don't have to look at the system. Anyway, what does it mean, the sisters? It's the way of a teacher like myself. O-R-E, the brothers. What does it mean? I look at the dictionary to make some sense. It is right underneath the ground. It is down. I know many of you know, but out of shyness, if you want to say it, has the very needed minerals, isn't it? Gold, silver, down there. Ore. So be like that. Be like that. Be strong. Be firm. Have good for everyone. Have good for everyone. Allah Jalla Jalla Rahman Rahmeen. Look at the hearts of Sahaba radiallahu anhu. First generation in Islam. They had all good for people in their hearts. And others don't have that. And that's why they were addressed. Kuntum khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas. But taken out, sent out for the welfare, for the goodness, for the betterness of people. Linnas. So when Allah Jalla Jalla Rahman Rahim looks at our hearts and finds that we have nothing but good for people, He subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to bridge this gap between us and people. And inshallah, through this will be means of the hidayat, the true guidance, and rahmat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then we come back to that. Two sohbah, two companionship. So three levels, three actions, and two companionship. Companionship, look for people of ilm, people who fill your heart with rahmah on yourself, and rahmah on your own family members, and rahmah on everyone around you. Look for them. Be around them. Be of those whom Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam addressed. Ar-Rahimuna yarhamhum ar-Rahman. Those who are kind, those who have rahmah, ar-Rahman, the most beneficent will have rahmah. And then how he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam addressed us. Irhamu man fil ard, yarhamkum man fil sama. Have rahmah on those who are in the earth. Man fil ard. Not just the people around you. We try to be nice to the next door neighbor so he will not, in summer, open his radio or his TV too loud and I'm doing something else. Try to be nice for them so they can be nice to me. That's not the good intention. You be nice to them for the sake of Allah. If they are nice or not, that's their own business. We have rahmah upon them. So in summer, Aisha is late, coming outside the masjid, chatting, talking over the phone. And some neighbors, they let their children go to sleep around 8, 3 hours before Salat al-Isha. And mashallah, I said, these people, why sleep early? It's not your business. It's their business. Sleep early or not. When you go out in the masjid, be sensible. If you heard anybody, any makhluk of Allah, is Allah happy with this? No. So صحبة العلماء, the jibam, it's from them. And then second, صحبة الجماعة, companionship of group. Group of people who stay in a masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Group people to come to the masjid, pray salat in the masjid, and teach them and learn with them du'as. Some people call it tabligh. I don't say tabligh, I say mashallah, this da'wah retreat. Go and stay in a masjid. You don't really do tabligh, but you yourself. And the sisters, mashallah, they go, they call it masturat, call it, mashallah, da'wah with sisters. Mashallah, be there. So you learn how to speak. You learn how to have rahmah in your heart. You learn how to connect people with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you adopt more sunnah in your life. And the sunnah itself is an attractive way to Islam. The way you drink, even the way you trim your nails. I try to teach my children, don't say cut your nails. It's not cut your nails, it's trim your nails. Anyway, and you start from here, there, this is the etiquette there. Yeah. It was related to me. I didn't see it. I didn't watch that. A sister was watching someone, his other Muslim sister, and starting her nail with this way. This one first, this one, this one, this one. And see, this is the second time you have like a particular way of trimming your nails. She said, this is the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the sunnah. I start from this, the pointing finger, I go to the middle finger, etc. And I end with the thumb. I said, your religion is so specific, leading your life in this way. And the conversation started. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Kareem Rahim. So any means, anyway, the way you drink, the way you eat, the way whatsoever you do is there. Because we've been accustomed to this, we don't see the nur. But others, they see the nur. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us to bring more life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam inside us. But before this life, what is called the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we try to have the surah, the attire, so look like the one you love, walking away as the one you love. You, mashallah, you don't accept anybody to say anything bad about Rasulullah. Present this. Don't be shy. Be confident. Let your way of walking, dressing, sitting, eating, speak out that you love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You're not shy of that. So the lesson we need to learn, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our life. Sarira, of course, first, what was in his heart to bring in our heart. And surah. And surah, the attire, may Allah save us from bringing in one's heart pride. When we study Kitab al-Shama'il, a good question was, if one to follow the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they meant, of course, the attire, the out, is it going to be good? I said, yes, it's going to be good, and can be means of destroying this person. So the students, the brothers and sisters, of course, destroying. Be in a way that people look at you and remember Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. From outside, can destroy yourself? Yes. Yes. If you have a very nice imam, do respect to imam. Mashallah, nice beard. And all the time you got the miswak. Mashallah, got your shilwar kameez. Mashallah, perfect. It's just from iron, mashallah, and you go back and change. You get, mashallah, nice iron one. Very smart. And this puts some pride in you, inside you. Some pride. Or look at somebody else with no beard. You think you are better than him. Why? Because you got some some hair here in your face. And who knows, he got more taqwa than you. He's closer to Allah than you. I don't mean, forget about the sunnah. It's not the core that you judge people or you start to put people in different categories because of their attire. No. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all to understand and take Islam as full and complete. And be those people, again I repeat, again this theme, who have rahmah and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalla rahmah adhan. اللهم امين يا رب. جزاكم الله خير. I will take some questions if you have any. بسم الله.
This is the time, Alhamdulillah, we have a short Q&A where we can ask our guests some questions. So if anybody has any questions, we can begin to
answer.
Sorry, any questions?
Any questions?
Speak loud. I trust inshallah. I didn't ask the sisters; they could hear me or not, because I shouted as much as I could. The sister, can you confirm?
More or less,
you could follow what I tried. So next time, inshallah, can you bring the mic?
Yeah,
inshallah.
The topic is how to tackle Islamophobia. So you want questions in regards to that? Go on then.
Can you stand so we can hear you, and the sister can hear you as well. Unless your mother or somebody, if you wait for him, she can tell what you try to say.
If
I'm not sure your mother there, no. Please.
If you convert to Islam and
you sorry?
If you convert to Islam and then you don't do the right thing first, then you don't do the right thing the first time. Is it accepted?
If I or someone converts to Islam, accepts Islam, and then is trying to be good Muslim, yet couldn't make it from the first time because he doesn't know much about Islam,
yeah.
That's no problem. Is he learning or she's learning?
He's learning.
He's learning. As long as we have the big L, and anyone even like me, but this is Imam that tells us from Al-Azhar, I even need bigger L. Because if I have a small learner, then I have a small chance of being forgiven. But if we say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, please. As Imam Shafi'i rahmatullah alayhi said, the more I learned, I was really ignorant. As if there was no real big space for me to learn, I wouldn't be able to learn. So the more you learn, the more you discover, oh, I was really jahil. I need more now. Same as you eat, and you eat more. And you say, I was really hungry, and you eat more. So I was really more hungry. You eat more. But with ilm, it will never be satisfied. And this is a sign that one is talib with ilm. May Allah accept all of us. Keep learning. And to be a good learner, you will never be satisfied. You will never reach a degree. You say, now I know. I have knowledge. And a sign of one to be real ignorant, may Allah save us from that, one thing, I learn now. I got the certificate, I got this ijazah, I got this license from my sheikh. I am okay, I know now. That's the time, may Allah save us, is real ignorant. Allah save us from that. So keep learning. Amen.
MashaAllah. Question. Go ahead.
Assalamu
alaikum. Alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Sheikh, I read on the internet about Ghazwa. And they portrayed Ghazwa as plundering. What is the real concept of Ghazwa in Islam?
This, who...
Ghazwa, the atheists said that they plundered.
Who answered this? Who Sheikh answered this? I can guess Sheikh Google, isn't it?
Yeah.
Sheikh Google, rahmatullahi. That's the problem. One of may Allah bless, one of the brothers. MashaAllah, you know the screen, the monitor is so bright. So you put like a man or something on the top and see how much nur is coming from.
So what's the real concept of Ghazwa? What?
Ghazwa, yadzu, is to go out.
And yes.
To go out and to stop people from coming, destroying.
So you go first?
Yes.
You go first. So it's like a surprise attack.
No. It's to go to stop them from attacking you.
Oh, right. Self-defense.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Any other questions about, in particular, Islamophobia? I want to keep the questions in and around the topic, which is Islamophobia and how to tackle Islamophobia.
Shukran. Good luck to start. I can hear you. The sister, did you hear about the Ghazwa? Yes? And we always looking for answer from Sheikh Google, Ya Rahman Kulari. Yes.
So you're obviously doing your time in time for the Muslims. One of the biggest issues that we have locally, I mean across the UK as well, is we're disunited as a Ummah, and we've got pockets of different communities except for the Muslims. What more can we do to unite us as in one community?
Let's say that Islamophobia, and I hope my dear friends of those who are promoting and working night and day and planning and being paid, they got time for Islamophobia and they promoting it. They're doing a very, very great job for us. For who? For Muslims. How? These small pockets and different sects and different school of thoughts, slowly being pushed to have this feeling that, look, they target all of us. They have no difference between any Muslim. They are about Islam. When they attack and there's something not very nice about our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we all know, all the Muslims, the billions and more, they were not happy. So if they understand and they can hear me, they're doing very, very good job. I don't mean continue, but yeah, okay, carry on your job. But let's understand the danger that we are in, and we are in the same place, same boat, and anything goes, hits everybody else. So let's pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make people who speak from the members, from the panel and tables like myself, to understand there is two areas we have to understand. Two areas. Area we can be different, and we're still Muslims, and we can still shake hands, and eat together, and alhamdulillah, this is myself and others. I go here and there and there, alhamdulillah, with all. But we don't compromise, it's fine, be different. I don't accept it. The hadith you say, to me is weak, I don't act upon it. You accept it, no problem. In the day of Qiyamah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will sort it out. We don't have to keep fighting here, no. And area, we cannot be different, we have to be one. Like the halal issue. Even the Shia, they want somebody, yes, petition. Even the Yahud, my friend said in the end of faith, yes, some Jewish, highly respected people, I know them. We help each other, even the matter of the face veil of women. They were there, they were supported. They don't have a problem with that. So if we can have dialogue, conversation with people who do not believe in Islam, shouldn't we have something in common and platform with Muslims? The time is coming. So alhamdulillah, these challenges or this Islamophobia is awakening many of us. There is one danger for all. And we have to open our eyes and work together. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to understand it. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. If I want to put how to treat Islamophobia with one word, that would be good?
Yes.
Would it be good? Yes. And you don't have to go to Google. I don't think it's yet in Google. Kufrophobia.
Huh?
Kufrophobia.
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 We have to work on this. But it's real phobia.
Yeah.
It's not irrational, it's not this. And this is Anbiya alayhi salam when they worked with that. They told their people the future is waiting for them if they deny Allah. And let's go a little bit to Arabic word, kafara. Kafara is one of the words that's amazing that somehow has the same meaning as in English. Kafara, isn't it? Kafara. And what's mean in English? If you say C-O-V-E-R, same root, kafara. Only the V that some Arab cannot say it. I tried, alhamdulillah, because I live here. It's fine. And I learned this from there, from Kairo, alhamdulillah. Okay? V and P as well. This is the other. You know the Pepsi when the Arab is like or someone, where can I park my car? You see, park your car anyway. Then you don't have to, where to park, park, park. Okay, so this cover has the same meaning. To cover something means it's existing, it's there, isn't it? So kuf and cover is to cover the fitra, the inborn nature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we all believe, each and every human is born as Muslims. May Allah make us to understand this. Ameen ya Rabbi. Your question. You are about to say something. Yeah. Yourself? Yeah? Yes. Did I not say this? Yes? You raise your hand and then you
can answer. Is there any hadith that the Prophet talks about regarding the end of times that we're tying to Islamophobia?
We started from day one and continue. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَسْمَعُنَّ مِنَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَمِنَ الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا أَذًا كَثِيرًا. You will. Here, you will find a lot of other, a lot of troubles, a lot of misconception, a lot of misunderstanding. But it is. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, when we do not do what we are sent for, they, these kuffar, these who cover this inborn pure nature, they deny that. And with due respect, is much, much better to explain to a non-Muslim instead of saying non-believer or infidel, to explain to them what is the term in Quran and Hadith, they say kafir, is very respectful. Is explaining just a fact. You cover something. That is all. You deny something. Okay, what's the problem with that? I believe it's there. You don't. So you have to excuse me. It's ever enough. Because something is also a big issue. Okay, evidence. We don't call that. We see kafir. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to understand the terms of Quran. I mean,
the last question we have is from the sisters. They're asking, how to keep morale high when every day we see something against Islam on the news and media. So how can we keep morale high amongst the Muslims when every day there is negativity about Islam in the news and media?
Be there, be active. Do something, mashallah. And I don't have to explain in psychology whatsoever it is, but to get rid of this phobia, any phobia, you have to get to explore, you have to expose. So the best is to go to your neighbor, say hello, how are you? And alhamdulillah, in Manchester, some sisters, they started this interfaith, ladies only, ladies. So we the brothers, we the men, we have our own and they have their own. And it was very, very successful, alhamdulillah, and inshallah it will restart again. They used to go and visit the masjid, visit the church, try to visit some of the synagogues. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help. So the sisters can make a lot. And alhamdulillah, be, as I say sometimes, be veiled, but don't veil. Be veiled, it's fine, to cover your face. Is something accepted between Sunnah and Shia, by the way. Veil, subhanAllah. There are few, not many. In Aqeedah, there are a lot of things. But in practice, they do accept the veil as well. He is covering the woman's face in Shia. And I have an answer. This is also from the internet. Yeah, from a very highly respected Shia website about veil, that is okay for a woman in Hajj or Umrah to cover her face. And the Shia site, I printed out in Arabic, it is recommended if she gets used to that and she, in a way, she has some beauty and she doesn't want, yes, she can cover, although she is in state of ihram. But veil and don't be veiled from activity in society. There is a meeting with the police. Attend the sister, go and attend, speak for yourself. There is a meeting for your local council. Why don't you go? There is a post to be a governor in your local school. What are you waiting for? Go and do it, isn't it? Be active. The sisters. Let not, this is my small advice to the sister, please. Yeah? Let not brothers or men to speak on your behalf. You speak on behalf of yourself. Is that what you want to say?